Coffee Roasting 15 miles from here. High Point Roasters, New Albany, Mississippi. So I took this camera with me on the trip to College Station this past weekend. So I'm a little bit late, but we don't have a game this weekend, so I thought I'd take my time, put this together, let you see a little behind the scenes of the trip. This is nothing that is a big production. I just kind of carried the camera, documented a few things so you can see what it's like traveling with the football team to a road game and back. And I've done it before. If you've watched some of the game day vlogs I've done here in the past, this is very similar. You've seen it before. The bus to the plane to this site. So yeah, I mean, I've done it before, but this is the most recent one. And now you can kind of see what it was like going to College Station, and State got a win, and it made the trip even better. There was an issue leaving campus to go get on the airplane. There are four buses with the team on it. And the first two are like offense, defense, or whatever. Third bus, I guess, got players and staff, and there's two. The fourth bus, we didn't have any players on that. That's the rest of us, you know, different staff members, video staff, radio guys, others. Some car tried to get in between the first two buses, and it ran the second bus off the road.
I know it. Could be a lot worse.
We weren't 3-4 miles from campus. Ran it off the road. He had to pull over off the road to avoid hitting the car, and got it stuck. Okay. And so every player, everybody on that second bus had to get off and filter onto the other three buses. And then we went on to the airport from there. So it was a little bit of a kind of a hairy, shaky start. Good flight, right about an hour, Columbus, Mississippi to College Station, Texas, and no problem on the flight. Get out there, land, and then jump on the buses, and they take you to the hotel. Neil Price, our play-by-play announcer, he found us a place to eat called Mi Pueblito, and it didn't look like much. Matter of fact, when we got there, I'm looking around thinking, this is a setup.
Hole in the wall.
It didn't look much on the outside, but on the inside, the food was outstanding. It tastes great. I mean, it was great Tex-Mex, Mexican food. So great meal that night, and then back to the hotel and hit the sack. So wake up on game day. I'm an early riser. I was up by 4 a.m. And so it means you got a long day at the hotel. Or at least a long day of waiting somewhere, because the game didn't kick off until 6 p.m. Central Time. Headed out, went and got some coffee. There was a Starbucks right down the street. Now, I like this coffee better, High Point Roasters in New Albany. It's good. It tastes good. It's not burnt. I didn't travel with any High Point Roasters coffee, and I couldn't buy any out there in College Station, and there was a Starbucks about... But I was the first one in the door when they opened at 5:30, and they looked at me like I was crazy. And then back to the room, got some breakfast that morning. Kick back, watch a little bit of football. The game started at 11. I started watching Arkansas and Georgia. We were on the bus with the managers and trainers headed to the stadium at 12:15 that day for a 6 p.m. game.
Grab Big balls and cows and we love.
And we go that early because our engineer takes all the equipment in and sets up the whole radio booth, has plenty of time to do it. So we spent the better part of the day basically just hanging out at Kyle Field up in the press box. Watching football on the monitors and the TVs in the press box up until the time that we started our ball game. Behind the scenes, you know, we're in the big, nice radio booth. Halftime show, got to pay a little attention to that. And man, let me tell you, the halftime show at Texas A&M, their band is incredible. Their atmosphere in their stadium really is unique. It's different. It's unlike any other place you're going to go. All the stuff they do, it's unlike anywhere else. It's a neat place to go. I really enjoy going every 2 years to get to see it. Makes it better when your team wins some, which we've seen them win over there twice in the time that I've been calling the games.
So Jonathan packing everything up afterwards, and it's no small task. That, a million wires, that, those headsets, this, backpacks, all of this. Well, yeah, technically it's yours, but still it's part of the trip. So all of that has to be packed up in two rolling cases.
All right, I'm going to close the window.
And then we'll be going home. Takes a little while.
On the bus, back over to the airport, get on the airplane and fly back. We flew all night. An hour. Get back to Golden Triangle area in Mississippi around 1 a.m., 1-ish, something like that. Takes a few minutes to get the buses loaded and then ride those back over to campus. You're off the buses and then you're on your own. Everybody goes home. Well, I live in Tupelo, so I'm an hour away from Starkville. So I had a place to stay, a condo in town, thanks to Overstreet Properties and my buddy Kane Overstreet. Plug. Anything residential in and around Starkville, permanent place to live or temporary, or just overnight, Overstreet Properties and OverstreetProperties.com. Bedded down and then woke up on Sunday morning, made a little coffee, poured it in my thermos for the trip, and jumped in the car and then drove back to Tupelo on Sunday morning. So it was a Friday, Saturday, Sunday, portions of 3 days and all of one trip. And like I say, when your team wins, it makes the trip that much better.
I don't see it.